Hello. Okay, The Equalizer 3, the final installment in the Equalizer trilogy starring Denzel Washington. I quite liked that first movie. I wasn't a massive fan of the second. But yeah, here we got The Equalizer 3 and we continue to follow Robert McCall as he finds himself in southern Italy. He befriends the local community but then finds out that they're under control of local crime bosses. So he finds himself in this position of protecting his friends from the mafia. So first of all, I just want to talk about the cinematography and that look of the movie, because I wasn't a massive fan of it. In parts it kind of works, especially the villa scene and just the lighting in that scene. It's in the trailers. I really dug it, and like a lot of other moments in the film, there's sort of the cinematography does work for sort of what the director is trying to do with the look of the movie. Almost like there's a tint of silver just running throughout the film, and the blacks are intensified as a result, but it just gives the film this kind of really muted, drab look, and just a very dull look to the picture, to the film, and to the cinematography. So in parts I kinda liked how it worked for certain scenes and certain moments, but as a whole just didn't work for me, and just makes the film, it just gives this film this very kind of dull and drab sort of vibe and feeling, and it's almost as if they do it intentionally to suck out the color out of the gore, because there's a lot of blood in this movie, but it's very dark. It's like almost like a dark brown, and it's almost like they give the film this certain look to kind of suck out the life of the out of these scenes that are very violent, very gory, and are supposed to make you go, oh, but I feel like because of the way the film was shot with this cinematography, it kind of lacks that grittiness, I felt, and sort of the kind of the impact really that you would be aiming for when it comes to these ultra violent scenes that do occur quite a bit throughout the film. Denzel Washington is one of the highlights for me when it comes to this film. He is wonderful in this role. He plays this character beautifully. I really like how the character is written. Right back to the first film, I just like the character's quirks and, you know, the quirks of his personality and just how Denzel Washington brings this character to life. He is really, really good in all three of these movies, and you could clearly see that he's enjoying playing this character. And when you do get the action scenes, when you've got Robert McCall going up against the mafia and killing them in all sorts of creative, gory ways, it is quite fun, it's quite cool, and it's always great to see rotten characters get beaten up in creative ways, but the problem here with the film's villains is they are very 2D and very cliched. There's nothing really to them, there's no depth, and you can just tell they're there so Denzel Washington can go in and just sort of give us some gory justice. You know what I mean? They are just sort of there so Robert McCall can fucking beat them to shit, and there's nothing much more to them. So the villains I thought were very, very weak. You know, there are moments within the film where you'll see the villain conduct a certain act of evil to sort of get you, the viewer, enraged. And you know, you fucking can't wait for Denzel Washington to do his thing, you know, deliver gory justice. But it's so cliched and predictable, and like we've seen it all before. There was nothing really new, and so it kind of really ended up lacking this sort of hook or focus or any emotional weight. And a lot of that is also sort of aided by the performances of the cast playing these villains. Like, they play the villains in a way that is, you know, look at me, I'm playing a bad guy. There's just like, there's nothing there on any kind of level, whether it be the writing or even through the performance. There's just no kind of depth to the character to really get you really immersed into what is going on, I feel. They're so 2D and cliched, like it, and it comes through with their performances as well. You know, it just has one of those I've seen it all before plots, and I like seeing Washington in this role, and he's clearly having fun playing this character. I always liked how the character was written and the quirks that come with his personality, but yeah, I feel he sort of gets lost among a lot of these other side stories that are very kind of clunky, and just the way it sort of comes together quite messy, and clearly just there to give us a reason to stick this character into another situation and have some sort of conclusion, which ultimately when it comes to the story's conclusion I felt was quite weak, and just like the overall film kind of lacked any weight and really lacked any punch. Dakota Fanning stars as Emma Collins, an agent that works for the US government, and I found her character to be incredibly annoying. She somewhat plays a pivotal part or a pivotal role within this story. She's involved in one of the side stories, but I just found her character to she just really grated on me, and a lot of that was through her very wooden performance. Like she just looked bored as fuck, I'll be honest. And when you put her next to Denzel Washington, who's clearly enjoying himself and just really sort of enjoying bringing his character to life, the contrast was just unbelievable. Dakota Fanning in this movie was terrible, and her character was annoying as fuck. So that kind of aspect of the story, for those of you that have seen the movie already, will understand what I'm on about. It just kind of really lacked any impact when it comes to this conclusion, and just sort of was more like a wet fart really when it came to that aspect of the story. I'm sorry, but just that's how I felt. My issue with these movies like this, I feel like they always lose touch or focus on what it was that made that original story work. The first movie was somewhat contained, it felt more personal and just a little bit more grounded, and I had more emotional weight to it. But when it comes to these sequels, they just seem to get a little bit more bloated, and they kind of just lose touch in what really made that first movie and those characters special. The only thing that keeps this sort of trilogy alive for me is Denzel Washington and his performance, and because he's given it so much. But other than that, when it comes to these two sequels, especially the third one, it just lacks any sort of weight, any focus, and sort of just that kind of personal touch to the movie where you've got someone, you know, you're supposed to really get emotionally invested into these characters' journeys, but unfortunately they really fail to bring that aspect of the movie alive. You're just sort of watching bad guys get killed by Denzel Washington doing a very good job of what he does, and that's about it, and as a result lacks any emotional weight and lacks any emotional punch. The first film, like the first movie, don't get me wrong, it's not the best thing ever, it's not, you know, but at least it had that kind of groundedness to it and that grittiness to it, but at the same time had an emotional weight and sort of had an experience where you could get immersed. And as these films have gone on, and it's like a lot of other movies like this, I could mention Taken as another example, where they kind of just lose touch of that, I want to call it magic maybe, and just perhaps get a bit too big for its own good and all of this. And so yeah, it just kind of loses touch of what made the original movie compelling. And yes, I rambled on a little bit too much there, but I think I got my point across. And when the movie starts, the sort of like the first act going into the second act, you sort of like, it has this kind of mystery to the story, because you're not really sure what Robert McCall is doing, you know, why he's in Italy. But when you do find out eventually why Robert McCall is doing what he was doing, I just felt like it lost any kind of impact. I just felt like this revelation, so, you know, us finding out why this character was on this journey was just a little bit too late. Because at this point, I've already kind of just not, I've unable to get immersed into the story. It's lacked that focus. It's lacked that emotional weight. And so by the time you do find out, for me anyway, personally, it's all just a little bit too late. Though at the same time, I always like that mystery aspect when it comes to these stories, and I don't want everything kind of spoon-fed to me. You know, I love the mystery aspect, but for me, it just, the way in which the narrative was told within this movie, it just didn't quite work. I have to mention the score by Marcelo Zavas. I think that's how you pronounce his name. Apologies if it's incorrect, but the music in this movie, I really, really dug. Sort of in those quieter moments and sort of those moments that's got a lot of mystery within them, I really kind of liked how the music had that kind of classical vibe about it. But then when it comes to the moments where Robert McCall is doing his thing and he's taking out the mafia, it sort of kicks into this kind of industrial sort of type of music, industrial kind of vibe, very similar to Nine Inch Nails. And I really dug that because I think it mirrored Robert McCall's character, sort of those two different sides of his character, very, very well. And I kind of like that contrast when it came to the score. So yeah, really, really dug the score by a Marcelo Zavas. So yeah, there's things I like. You know, this is by no means a terrible movie. There are going to be people out there, it might be one of you, who like this movie a hell of a lot more than I did, or even hated the movie more than I did. I didn't hate this movie. Just a lot of it, you know, just the overall experience just didn't quite work for me. But there are aspects throughout that I appreciated here and there, kind of liked. But overall, I just felt like it kind of lost touch of what that original movie was for me personally. And like I said, there are aspects of the film, sort of from the filmmaking side of it, that I kind of liked and appreciated. But overall, I just think the film lacked any kind of hook or any focus. It just kind of failed to really immerse me and lacked any sort of emotional weight. It's worth, for me, it's worth watching, and I would watch this again just for Denzel Washington. I love what he does with the character and how he brings his character to life. Unfortunately, it's not really the conclusion I wanted for this character that I was first introduced to back in, I believe it was 2014. I can't get over it. It was that long ago. It only feels like yesterday that I first seen that in the first Equalizer film in the cinema. But yeah, for me personally, this was an unsatisfying conclusion to the Equalizer trilogy. So yeah, they are my thoughts on the Equalizer 3, and I will be giving it a 4.5 out of 10. So yeah, they are my thoughts on the Equalizer 3. Have any of you seen it yet? Then please let me know below. Did you love it? Did you hate it? Or did you agree with me where I'm sort of in the middle? Then let me know below and let's get a discussion going. And if you've made it this far into the video, thank you so much. I really do appreciate it. If you want to see future reviews from just some random Welsh geek rambling on, then please hit the subscribe button. It will mean an awful lot to me. My next review will be for the third episode of Ahsoka. I do have a review coming for Cobweb. Now, that was supposed to be the beginning of the week, but unfortunately, I never got around to actually seeing it at the advanced screening. So that will be arriving this weekend. So I'm looking forward to checking that out. So yeah, two reviews on the way, Ahsoka Episode 3 and Cobweb. That's enough rambling on from me for now. Thank you for watching, I really do appreciate it, and I'll be catching you guys soon.